Hi, I'm Michael, and I look after the pump program here at CSI. Last time we met, we talked about the five things you need to know when you're selecting a pump. This time, what we're going to cover is how to choose the appropriate mechanical or shaft seal. We can all agree there's no magic bullet, there's no one size fits all when it comes to shaft seal selection, but we can also agree that a pump is only as good as its mechanical seal. So with that in mind, let's talk a little bit about the types of seals that we commonly see here at CSI. We generally deal with customers that are in the hygienic liquid market, which means food, dairy, beverage, biopharm, biotech. So we're not really into power or petrochem. So if you're thinking about particular seals for those industries, we won't talk about it much here. Most commonly we see either single O-ring, double O-ring, single mechanical with flush, which we'll talk a little bit about in a minute, or double mechanical with flush. Single mechanical and double mechanical with flush being two of the most common types, especially for centrifugal pumps. But let's start back at the single O-ring. When we're talking about O-ring seals, these are mostly intended for folks who are going to daily strip. And daily can be whatever you mean it to be, but what we mean is at the end of the shift or at the end of the day or a couple of days, these pumps are going to be broken down. These O-rings are going to be taken out and discarded. So whether you're talking about single O-ring or double O-ring, the operating principle is largely the same and mostly intended for folks who are going to break those pumps down on a regular basis and then discard those seals when they're done with them. We shift gears and kind of go to the single mechanical versus double mechanical. These types of seals are for pumps that are typically going to be longer in service in between services, and also those pumps that are going to be cleaned by some automatic process like CIP or clean in place. So we see single mechanical selected a lot for basic applications. You may have a water application, milk, animal fat, some sort of a beverage or food processing. That's a pretty general application. So when do you shift gears and think about a different kind of seal? When is a single mechanical seal not enough? We start to think about something other than single mechanical when the application tells us to. So we think about the liquid or the fluid actually being processed and we say, is there something about that liquid that is challenging or dangerous or difficult? Some of those examples of challenging could be sticky or sugary products. You might have a fluid that if it sets up a little bit, can start to crystallize, can cause buildup to occur between the seal faces. And as you can imagine, you have two seal faces which are intended to ride flat on each other. One is going to be held stationary and one is going to be rotating while the pump is operating. So what you want to make sure of is if that fluid that you're pumping is going to leave some sort of debris behind, you'll want to use something other than a standard single seal. And that's when we get to the flushes. One of the types of flush that Alfa Laval offers that not a lot of other centrifugal pump manufacturers offer is a single mechanical with flush. It gives you the benefit of having a single mechanical seal, and it also gives you the benefit of having a flush where you don't have to go all the way to a double mechanical seal with flush, which can save you time and energy and, to be quite honest, can save you some money. So you get the principles of a single mechanical seal, and then you also get the flushing action, which will take care of those particulates and residues that are left behind from some of those sticky or difficult products to deal with. It's important to note here, the reason why that flush is so instrumental is because the seal itself is always lubricated by, when the pump is running, by the fluid inside of the pump. And then if the pump were sitting still, it's still wetted on the backside of the seal from the flush itself. So when you have a sticky or viscous or some sort of a difficult product, that flush is always going to be helping the backside of the seal stay clean and clear from debris as well. We also hear sometimes when people are talking about a pump running dry, flush can be very important, can be critical then as well, because when the pump isn't in operation, no problem, but once the pump is running, but there's no fluid in the actual volute itself, then that seal flush will actually keep the seal quenched. It'll actually keep the seal cooled and lubricated because that fluid passing through the seal face is what actually lubricates the seal. So we talked about single mechanical, where you just have your rotating seal and you have your stationary seal. And then we talked about single mechanical with flush, which is primarily the same setup, except the flush on the back side of the seal to keep it flush as well. Then you move into another category that we commonly see, which is a double mechanical with flush. To be really honest, the double mechanical with flush is really only needed when the product is hazardous in some way. Hazardous can mean a lot of things to many people. That can mean maybe it's an acid, maybe it's some sort of a solvent. It's something that the end user doesn't want escaping from the seal section. So if the primary seal were to fail, then the secondary seal is responsible for making sure that the product that they don't want sort of spraying out of the pump ending up somewhere where they don't mean for it to. Double mechanical seals get applied a lot. They get selected a lot, and I think the primary reason is because most manufacturers don't offer both a single flush and a double mechanical with flush. So once they go past a single and they need that flush, they have to go all the way to double mechanical with flush to sort of seal the deal. So again, single flush is an option that can sort of hit the middle ground for a lot of applications. So thank you for joining me in this video series where we talk about pumps, we talk about seal selection, we talk about the things you need to know to select a pump. We talk about the things that can cause your pumps to fail prematurely. If you have additional questions or you have problems, give us a call. I'm Michael, I look after the pump program here. You can reach us on our website at csidesigns.com, or you can give us a call, 800-654-5635. Thanks.